a lot of cleaning every day. They do some vacuuming and scrubbing of the tank to divers. Come on this side. Alright, so here we have our diver. This is Lani. He's from India. And my friend right there, that's Charlie. He's from the Philippines, just like myself. So hi divers, is everything okay? Yes, Charlie? Hi, Lani. Okay. So our divers, they also assist guests who likes to dive inside. And also, today they will be showing us what's the uses of their equipment. So the first item will be the weight belts. The weight belts help the diver sink underwater. So depending if they're kind of skinny or big, the weight belts help them sink underwater. So divers can be showing you weight belts. There you go. That's the weight belt right there. Help them sink underwater. So the next item, the next equipment will be the BCD jacket or the buoyancy control device. The jacket now helps the diver float underwater. So with the help of the weight belt and the jacket, helps them move up and down. So divers, can you please show us your jacket? There you go, the jacket leaks. Alright, so there is a switch which helps them inflate or deflate the jacket. Them go up and down the surface. Thank you, divers. So behind the BCD jacket is a cylinder. It contains a compressed air, helps to breathe underwater. Divers, can you please show us your cylinder? Oh, come on, not your muscles. You don't even have one. No, no, no. The cylinder. Turn around, please. There you go. The cylinder contains a type of gas, which is air, helps them breathe underwater because we're not like fishes. So for them to get the air out of the cylinder, they'll be needing the regulator. The regulator is the device inside them, in their mouth, helps them get the air from the cylinder. Divers, can you please show us your regulator? Oh, stop blowing me kisses, I'm already taken, come on. Regulator. Show us the regulator. There you go. So that's the regulator. And the air bubbles, that's the air inside the cylinder. Thank you, divers. So for our next equipment, for them to know how much air they have in their tank, they'll be needing the pressure gauge. The pressure gauge is a clock-like device. Let them know how much air they have left. So, for example, they just do a little scrubbing in there. They won't take much air. So, divers, can you please show us the pressure gauge? Yeah? So, this is the signal when you ask them the pressure gauge. The pressure gauge. There you go. Come on. Show us your pressure gauge, please. So, it's a clock-like device. Depending on how much time that they need. Or how much. So, this will let them know how much air they have left in their cylinder. Thank you. So for our last two items, I'll be needing your phone for them to demonstrate how it works in a real life situation. It's a rule in diving that you have to swim in pairs. Because something goes wrong, you have your buddy to assist you. So would you like Lali or Charlie to demonstrate they're going to be running out of air? So raise your hand if you want Lali to run out of air for us. Yeah? One? You have one vote. You have one vote. How about Charlie? You want him to run out of air? Yeah? Raise your hand. One. Come on, madam. Two, three, four. You have four votes. So you have to run out of air. Yes, you run out of air. So this is the signal if they're going to run out of air. Oops. So if this case happens in a real life situation, he will give his buddy a signal that, hey, I'm running out of air. And the buddy will give him the extra regulator, which is an octopus, the yellow one. They will be sharing the same air from one cylinder. They will hold their hand, give the okay sign, and go straight up in the surface. They don't need to do anything down there because they'll be sharing more air from one cylinder. Thank you, guys. So for our last item is water, so we'll be needing the face mask. They say a good diver can remove his face mask, put it back on without going up in the surface. This is the